Once again, I greet all of you in the name of the Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. I think I don't need a message to preach after the good testimony. And sister, she could have preached. And she's a better preacher. So maybe next time you'll enjoy. Even today we are enjoying. Whenever we are in the presence of God, the Lord satisfies us. Hallelujah. Nothing else can satisfy us. If you really have a hunger for the Lord, the presence of God is the greatest thing that can satisfy you. May this morning be a day of satisfaction. We are in God's house. We are in God's house. Hallelujah. Tell someone, welcome to God's house. Doesn't look like it's a warm welcome. Give a warm welcome. Tell them, you are welcome to the house of God. So we are in God's house. Now you tell them, God's house, you are welcome to God's house. You don't understand. Hebrews 3:6 says, we are God's house. When we say God's house, we mean the building. God is not in a building. God is not in a cathedral. He is in us. Shall we read? The clock is running very fast today. Whenever I come here, the clock runs very fast. Anyway, I think it's a miracle. Hebrews chapter 3, verse 6. Can somebody read, please?
But Christ, as the Son over his own house, whose house we are, if we hold fast the confidence and the rejoicing of the hope, firm to the end.
It says, but Christ as a son over his own house, whose house we are. We are God's house. Hallelujah. Our body is the temple of the living God. I will give you three characteristics of God's house. If you are the house of God, if you are a God's house, there are many things, but just for the time's sake, I will give you three things, three important things. Number one, to make it short, God's house is holy. Holiness will be seen. Holiness will be reflected. Let's turn to the Bible, 1 Corinthians chapter 3, verse 16. It says, know ye not that you are the temple of the living God? Where we live, we call the place where we live is a house. But here, where God lives, the place is called temple. A better word. We live in a house, but we are the temple of the living God. So we are God's temple. God's temple is holy. The Bible immediately says, know ye not that you are the temple of the living God? And you are that temple. God's temple is holy and you are that temple. Shout a hallelujah. If we say that I'm a temple of God, if I say that I'm a child of God, the basic thing that should be reflected in my life is not riches or education or blessing, holiness. Holiness. God created everything, millions, trees, stars, the whole universe, millions in numbers. But when he created man, he created only one. Though he had power, Malachi chapter 2, verse 15 says, though he had power to create everything in millions, he created man only one. Because when he created man, he had a plan to have a godly generation. To have a godly generation. Hallelujah. Christ came into the world to make us holy. I usually always say, man always wants to be jolly. You know, Friday night, Saturday, weekend. Some people, long weekend. For some becomes dead end. Long weekend. No church, no worship, no service. Long weekend. If they have Monday also holiday, long weekend. And Sunday they come very weak. Because previous week, no church. Many are like that. They want to be happy. Man, in everything, oh, can I be happy? Can I be happy? Can I be jolly? God's ways are always holy. Man's ways are always jolly. God's ways are different from man's ways. Shout a hallelujah. In everything, God wants us to be holy. Holiness is not something that we show outside. It starts from inside. If anyone is in Christ, he is a new creature. Inside, transformation. Inner transformation. Holiness must start from inside. Shout a hallelujah. So we have to be every day paying more attention on holiness. Am I holy? Because I am God's house. In your house, you know what to keep, where to keep, how to decorate, how to keep it clean. You have many plans for your house. And you make it this way for your taste. You just put certain things here, there, here and all. You make beautiful. I stayed in many houses, really beautiful. We know how to make it beautiful, clean, especially everywhere, the restroom, this and that. We know, but God wants us to be holy, or He wants us to reflect holiness in our life so that we can be called the house of God. Are we the house of God? The Bible says, we are God's house. Always remember, this body is the temple of living God. If you want to be holy, if you want to have a holy life, you must have a decision. Holiness doesn't come automatic. In the church, when we come, sleep comes automatic. For some people, they come like, no, by the time they go, they cast their burden upon the Lord. Biblical. And somebody asks, why you are sleeping? Oh, the Lord is pleased on me. For everything they have scripture verses. I asked one man, why you are opening your eyes and praying? Pastor, don't you know? It says watch and pray. They are pastors to pastors. May God give us grace to pastors, to lead these pastors, to shepherd these pastors. Shout a hallelujah. Pastor, when you come to India, come to our church. We love to have you too. You said, wondered, I will 3 days retreat with you. Because India, no time, no clock. Only Holy Spirit. Here, time bound. When you get in train, outbound, inbound. Here, time bound. There's no boundary. So we'll have to have you. I really enjoy. When we are called God's house, there are certain things that we have to observe. The basic thing is holiness. As I told you, when you sit here, automatically we sleep. When you sit here, automatically hunger comes. Fasting won't come. You have to take time. Decide for fasting. Especially in this country, always feasting. Eating after every meeting. In India, we say, what to eat? Here you open the refrigerator, say, what to eat? Because it's overflowing. I was in Australia, came back. People asked me, how was the meeting? I said, no meeting, only eating 5 days. Eating 5 days, 2 days meeting. Feasting. These are all automatic. Hunger automatic. Thirst automatic. Sleep automatic. But holiness is not automatic. You have to have a decision. Unless you decide for holiness, holiness will never come. Holiness must start here. In your eyes, in your hearing, in your thought life. Someone said, watch your thoughts, for they become your words. And watch your words, for they become your action. And watch your action, that becomes your character. And watch your character, that becomes your destiny. Hallelujah. Everything starts here. Yesterday I said Brooklyn, capital. Be careful with the capital. It's the capital of the country. Head. Everything starts here. We can show ourselves very holy outside. But inner life is more important. Because God is more concerned about inside. 2 hours when we come into the church, we sing, we shout, everything. Really beautiful songs. I need you every moment. Not for blessing, I tell you. We need God every moment. Beautiful song. Not for blessings. Not for protection. Above all, I need you every moment to live a holy life. Holiness. Holiness. That's the beauty of the temple. You know that? Psalm 93 verse 5. Let's read. Psalm 93 verse 5.
Your testimonies are very sure.
Yeah.
Holiness adorns your house, O
Holiness
Lord.
Adorns your house. And in my Bible it says in Tamil, holiness adorns your house eternally. Forever. It's not temporary. To make our house beautiful, we have many things. To make a building beautiful, we have many things. But holiness is the only beauty cream that you can apply to make your life beautiful. Beauty cream. You have a lot of creams now. Every day we buy something, this and that. When there is an advertisement, we go for that to make ourselves beautiful. And finally we look at, oh, it's not good. Nothing satisfies. One day this way, one day that way, one day this way, one day this way, one day this way. I pray for a person, it was like a knife here. I touched. People know how to make this way, make our lives holy. God wants us to be holy. Holiness, let holiness be the beauty of our life, my brothers and sisters. Our speech will be holy. Our thinking will be holy. Our meditation will be holy. Let holiness reflect. Brothers and sisters, God has brought you here to reveal and reflect the holy God in this generation. We are living in the midst of an ungodly generation. When Peter preached, when people saved, 3,000 people were baptized. But before baptism, he said, separate yourself from the ungodly generation. Keep your life holy. So God's house must be holy. Number two, God's house must be, it's a house of dedication. It's a house of holiness. It's a house of dedication. Please read 1 Kings chapter 7. Chapter 8, 1 Kings chapter 8, verse 63. 1 Kings chapter 8, verse 63.
And Solomon offered a sacrifice of peace offerings, which he offered to the Lord, 22,000 bulls, and 120,000 sheep. So the king and all the children of Israel.
So the king and all the Israelites. They dedicated the house of the Lord. God's house is a holy house. Or God's house is a house of holiness. So holiness is the symbol. It's the sign. Holiness is a sign. Number two, dedication is a sign. What is dedication? We know child dedication when you come to church. We have church building, no? Building dedication. We dedicate it for a special cause. Only certain things will happen here and some things will not happen here. Some churches it's written, no? No food, no drinks in the sanctuary. You know, they have discipline. No food, no eating, no drinking. In Singapore, at least, trains they have written. Eating or drinking not allowed in trains. To keep the train clean. If we are God's house, we must be dedicated for God. This body is the temple of the living God. Daniel decided not to defile himself through food. He was not going for movies or that. Through food. Because that was offered to idols. And God says here, if you are God's temple, if you are God's house, there is no connection between idols and temple. It comes in 2 Corinthians chapter 3. Second Corinthians chapter 6. Verse 16.
And what agreement has the temple of God with idols?
The first line, that's enough, I think. It says, what agreement has the temple of God in idols? We have seen idols in every temple in India. Here the verse is different. There is no connection, agreement between the temple and the idol. Because we are the temple. We are God's house. We have no connection with idols. What is an idol? We may not have literally an idol in our house. Whatever takes the place of God, that's an idol. Our job, our friends, our money, our priorities. Whatever takes the place of God, that's an idol. Sister beautifully said, decide today. Let there be a decision. Nothing will separate me from the love of Christ. Every day, standing before the mirror and telling the Lord, Lord, I love you more than anything in the world. More than my money. So there is no connection between idols and a temple. Many people have job as their idol. They run. And they have money. Some people, money is their God. So they don't respect. When they come to church, they come like some VIP. We are here to learn. Amen. We are here to worship God. We are all children of God. We must have a decision. If you want to be holy, holiness comes on the basis of a decision. Daniel kept himself holy. He said, I will never defile. The young man, he was 16, you know that. When Daniel was brought to Babylon, he was 16, teenager, away from the parents, away from the country. If he does something, nobody can see. But he had the fear of God. Whoever sees or not, my God is seeing me. And I will never defile myself. I will keep myself holy. Decision to keep himself holy. Dedication is decision. We call the parents, when they bring the child for child dedication. And I teach the parents, because child doesn't understand anything. Be simply looking at me. And it will, by the way it looks, it will tell me. I tell the parents, see, your child is telling me to teach you properly. That's what I understand when she looks at me. So listen, and again it will look at me. Sometimes it will cry. I'll say, oh, it's crying, you are not obeying. So message is for the parents. I ask them, will you grow this child in a Christian manner? You have an expectation for the child, certain things to do. What you expect from your child, will you do? What you expect from the child that she shouldn't do, will you be careful not doing that? Parents, yes. On the basis of that agreement and decision. Some people forget that on the day itself. But we ask them, do you have a decision to make the child a child of God? Yes. So we teach the parents decision, child dedication, building dedication. We, Lord, we will never allow that defiles our life into our building, oh God. Hallelujah. There was a church in Boston. And Sunday there's a service. And that building was allowed for everybody. It's like they were renting. And Saturdays, some people come there and they dance, they drink, they acted, and many immoral things happened. Just for the money's sake, the building was rented. And it was the shocking news. For them, it's not a sin. For many people, many things are not sin. But always, God is looking at sin as sin. He doesn't have a second word. Shout a hallelujah. You may not think it's a sin, but God, in the sight of God, what is sin? It's sin. That's why David said, Lord, search me. 139, Psalm, verse 1, he says, Lord, you know me. He starts with a psalm, Lord, you know me. You have searched my heart. But at the end of the psalm, he says, Lord, search me one more time. If it is anything wrong in your sight, I will correct it. Shout a hallelujah. Dear brothers and sisters, if you are God's building, if you know that you are God, you live according to a personal decision for the Lord. You must have a decision for the Lord to get up, to pray, to come. When you go to a restaurant, you know how to behave. But for many people, when they come to a church, they don't know how to behave. When you go to a restaurant, you know how to pay. How much you have to pay? 15%. God is asking only 10%. Can I hear an amen? Only 2-3 amen. We know prestige. After eating, we know how to give. Otherwise, what they will think? We know how to behave in many places. When you go to a Walmart, when you go to a shop, you know how to say thank you. When they say thank you, when they have a good day, we say, oh, you too. All we know. But when we come to church, we don't open our mouth. Put a big zip here and you zip your lip. I tell you, open your mouth. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Thank the Lord. Sometimes we eat. Yesterday, Pastor gave me a very good dinner in the night after coming from Brooklyn. The problem was, before you order the main meal, they give you some appetizer, no? That fills the stomach. I ate one small banana and had a big cup of drink. I thought, I'm not going to have my main meal. I should have canceled it. Then when it comes, no, only half could eat. But whatever we eat, this factory perfectly works. What is not boiled in the cooker, boiled perfectly here. Everything, whatever goes in, praise the Lord. Amen. Yes, Lord. And again, in 3 hours, we are ready for the next meal. What a grace we have, no? Our Madhya Pradesh, perfect. If Madhya Pradesh is perfect, Uttar Pradesh is okay. Then you are very sad because here empty. Tell you, God is so gracious, no? The health, the digesting system. Hallelujah. What a loving God we have. What a caring God. What a sustaining God. Live for Him. Keep this body for Him. Let nothing defile this body. Let nothing, there's a decision. There is no agreement with the idols, it says, because we are God's temple. God's temple is holy. Holiness is our beauty. Hallelujah. When you, next time you stand before the mirror, try to put up some cream that will make you beautiful. Not only beautiful, holy. Pray and find out some cream somewhere. You will never get anywhere except in the Word of God. Here you get a lot of cream. Hallelujah. Put a cream here, you won't speak lies. Holiness is the beauty. God's temple's beauty is holiness. Number two, God's temple is a temple of, as a house of dedication. We live on decision. Hallelujah. Every day morning, 4 o'clock, we have to get up in our church. The assistant pastors, they have to come to the church. And 4:45, church hall, everything will be ready. And 5 o'clock, we have a service. Pastors, they have to come. Wednesday morning, all the leaders must come. Sunday school teachers, carousel leaders, pastors, full-time, part-time. And people who take offering. Whoever has a responsibility in the church, everyone, Wednesday, early morning, I take the service. Some don't come, but we tell them, come, people come. That's a decision. Daniel decided not only to defile himself, he decided to pray 3 times. We talk about Daniel too much. But we don't do like Daniel. In Tamil, we have a song, as like Daniel, Daniel Pola. We sing every 100 times in a month. Like Daniel, I must pray. But not even one day they pray like Daniel. Not only he prayed 3 times, he knelt down and prayed. That's also a decision. If you don't have a decision, you will not kneel down. After having a lot of facilities and blessings from the Lord, we have become so lazy and comforted. We are in a comfort zone. Many have forgotten the neology. You know, this is neology. Theology here, neology here. Even today, I tell you, this early morning, 3:30, I got up and prayed. I had some chapters to finish from Jeremiah, completed 52 chapters. Within these 2 weeks, I read Isaiah and Jeremiah. More than 100 chapters. Traveling, jet lag. When preaching time comes, I feel sleepy. When there is time to go to church, I feel sleepy. That kind of, no, because traveling here and there, and sometimes the weather very bad. You feel like speaking in tongues. It's automatic. That kind of shivering. That's what I'm saying. Still, when you get up early morning, got up 3:30 until 5:30 to 6, reading, praying. I tell you, I'm standing here with a bold heart that I stood before the Lord. That's why He helped me stand before you this morning. Decision. And phone comes. No, I'm going to church. Somebody calls. No, I will not take the phone. I'm reading Bible. I'm praying. I'm going to worship. Decision. And I will give. When I went to Malaysia first time, I said, in India, Lord, we give 10 rupees. Or 10 rupees, no, some 20 years before, that's big money in India. 10 rupees is bigger, sometimes 50 rupees. When I went to Malaysia, the Lord blessed me. So I said, Lord, in every service, one Sunday I preach 4 services. Every service I will give better than what I gave in India. 50 ringgit every Sunday. Not only once, all the services. Usually people don't come to the pastor, no. But we voluntarily do that because of decision. Shout a hallelujah. I will do like this. I will do it. It's a decision, my brother. What is your decision for God today? You have a decision for God. When Daniel decided for God, there was a reward. When you have a decision, whatever you do for the Lord, there is a reward, I tell you. 3 times, kneeling down, when the verse was written in chapter 6, verse 10, Daniel, he was more than 80. His age was more than 80. We know the culture. We know the system. We know the fashion of the world. I tell you, whatever you do, let holiness be reflected in your life. Let people say that you are the temple of God. Let us not be like others. Let us not, praise God for this country. 3 years, Daniel and his friends were given great and good, very solid training to change them as Babylonians. But 3 years of training could not change them, but they changed Babylon. Shout a hallelujah. Are you a conformer or a transformer? Few are transformers, others are conformers. Tell the Lord, Lord, nothing will change me. I will change this country. In our speech, in our dressing, everything, let God be glorified. Remember, whenever next time when you dress up, I am God's temple. And priest, no, what's the priest? How his dress must be? From here to here. Here to here. Read Bible. Bible, it's not easy thing, but we have to follow. We have to decide. God's temple is holy. And God's temple is a temple, it's a house of dedication, decision. When you have a decision for God, the Bible says, He decided to pray 3 times, He became one among the 3 in the country. Daniel, his progress, and one above the 3. The king wanted him to be above all the supervisors, about 120 countries. Shout a hallelujah. Prayer will lift you high. When you have a decision for God, your life will be lifted up, I tell you. Not the decisions of the world, decision for God. Try to get up early morning, my brothers. If I can, a traveler, a pilgrim, I'm here with jet lag and all. If I can get up early morning and pray, why not you? Why not? Saturday means sleeping day. Sunday means resting day. No, I have more time to read Bible. I have more time to worship God. I have more time to call somebody. I have more time to take somebody, bring somebody into church. Shout a hallelujah. Let me do something more. When the Bartimaeus, the blind man, when he had problem, when people said no, he shouted more, the Bible says. Let us do something more. Shout a hallelujah. And number 3, God's house is a prayer house. Shout a hallelujah. I already finished that. Isaiah. The book of Isaiah, kindly read please. The book of Isaiah, chapter 56, verse 7. 56, 7. Isaiah 56, 7. It says, my house shall be called the house of prayer. Amen. My house shall be called the house of prayer. Hallelujah. God's house is a prayer house. God's house is a holy house. God's house is a dedicated house. Anything cannot be done there. Everything cannot be done. Only certain things can be done because it's dedicated for God. And number three, God's house is a prayer house. My house, we are God's house. We must be prayer house. Prayer every day, not only Sunday, not only Friday, but not only when you have prayer in the church, every day. Hallelujah. The Bible says, pray always. There was only one man about him, it's written in the Bible, who prayed always is Cornelius. Acts chapter 10, he was a man, he was not a man without job. He was a man, no? He was an authority. He had 100 soldiers under him. He was a centurion. But the Bible says he prayed always. We can have the spirit of prayer. Not that kneeling down, lifting hands, but have the spirit of prayer. Wherever you go, when you take the car, when you drive, when you go everywhere, when you see some people, when you are in the street, when you are in a bus, wherever you are, you can have the spirit of prayer and keep yourself connected with God. That's what needed. God's house is prayer house. Shout a hallelujah. And there are three blessings also. I'll read and finish. In Psalm 65, Psalm 65, when you keep your life, 65 verse 4, Psalm 65 verse 4, there is goodness, we shall be satisfied with the goodness, that means good things will come. Psalm 23:6 says, surely goodness and mercy will follow me. Shout a hallelujah. If you are careful to keep your life as God's temple and God's house, there will be goodness always. The pain will go, the agony will go, the days of your sorrow will come to an end. Shout a hallelujah. There is goodness. And number two, when you keep your life, there's glory. When Solomon dedicated, there's no time to read. When Solomon dedicated the building, glory came. Glory is the presence of God. Not only in the church, everywhere you can experience the presence of God. Shout a hallelujah. And when you have the presence, the Bible says, in his presence, the mountains can melt. Your problems will disappear. You focus more on the presence of God, not on the problems. When presence comes, problems disappear. Shout a hallelujah. And number three, there is a blessing, not only blessing, not only glory, not only goodness, not only glory, there is joy. The Bible says, the same verse what we have read, Isaiah 56:7. He says, in my house of prayer, I will make them joyful. I will make them happy. Joy will be there. Shout a hallelujah. Dear brothers and sisters, how is our life? We come to God's house, but are we really mindful that we are God's house? Let us always keep this body as the temple of the living God. Holiness, let holiness be our supreme priority. And there will be joy, there will be goodness, there will be mercy, there will be blessings, and you lack nothing. Shout a hallelujah. Shall we all stand for a moment?